The psalmist wrote, "My lips will shout for joy when I sing praise to you, O God, because you have redeemed me."
Redeemed? What does that mean?
To redeem something is to buy it, to own it, a release from one owner to another.
What does the psalm mean? How can God redeem you or me?
That's the story we've come to tell today. It began over 2,000 years ago in Jerusalem. Jesus' death on the cross took the place of the ancient ritual of animal sacrifice for the sins of the people. His blood paid our debt once and for all.
It's hard to understand how Jesus' life has paid my ransom.
Yes, but the cross was essential to our redemption.
Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "It is finished." The curtain of the sanctuary was split in two from top to bottom. He breathed his last.
Thank you.
on the cross. He even redeemed us from death by rising from the dead.
So, we will no longer die?
We will no longer die eternally. These bodies are only temporary, but our spirits live forever, and we can live in heaven in new bodies even after our old bodies were.
Bibles to Luke 24. chapter 124, verses 1 to 4. We'll be reading through chapter 24 today. Now, most people do not believe in the impossible. What I mean about that is that you can look at miracles that have occurred in people's lives, and logic or science does not have an answer to those miracles. People in general actually do not believe in the supernatural events that occurred. And when we hear about amazing, impossible stories, the words we often say is, no way. That's impossible. That's fake. That's not real. And so when we look at Easter, what it means to the Christian community, that Jesus Christ died, was buried, and 3 days later rose from the grave, its definition hangs on the supernatural, an unbelievable miracle that Jesus, who claimed to be the Son of God, the Messiah, died and was buried, and then 3 days later rose from the grave. And not only rose from the grave, he appeared to his disciples and to many other witnesses. And so this is what Easter is about, that Jesus Christ died and 3 days later is alive. He is risen. You see, this truth, by definition, is impossible for any scientific explanation, or and exactly by logic, this cannot happen, because someone who is clearly dead and was buried cannot come back to life. And it's logically impossible. And so when we look at this story of the Bible, and the people who were actually there, they were also not convinced that Jesus rose from the grave and is alive. They heard the eyewitness account that the stone was rolled away, right? And even after hearing these events, they were not convinced by the eyewitness accounts, by Mary and Mary Magdalene, of seeing Jesus. In fact, Peter and the disciples wanted to see Jesus for themselves. And so this morning, as we celebrate Easter, the truth is, you will either believe that Jesus is alive, or you won't believe that he's alive. You will either believe he is your Savior and King, and you are excited to be here this morning, or you're here because you want to be a good son, friend, someone invited you. Thank you, if I invite you, thank you for coming. But the truth is, Easter has no significance in your life. It's just a holiday. It's a Christian holiday. This morning, I want us all to wrestle with this question. Did Jesus really come back to life? And is he alive today? Because finding the answer to this question will either propel you and your family to either follow him with complete abandonment, because again, if you truly believe he is the risen King, then you will not live like the status quo, just living your life and not having meaning to your life. But again, you would believe that it's not some idle tale or some myth long ago. Because the truth is, Easter, and for the kids, this is the truth, Easter is not about bunnies. It's not about candy. No. It's not even about people attending church once a year, or because it's your cultural tradition, or it's your religious practice. No. Easter is not that. Easter's bigger, it's larger, it's more important than any holiday you could ever think of. In fact, it's bigger than your birthday, Philippine. Sorry, it is. It's bigger than your wedding anniversary. It's bigger than your debut. It's bigger than our church anniversary. It's bigger than your graduation. You see, Easter, when truly grasped and understood with your heart, with your mind, with your soul, it will take your breath away. Because it will make you cry with thankfulness like a little child, because you truly have understood and experienced and found your true Father, your heavenly Father, who truly loves you unconditionally, who created you in His own image and knows every single desire, every single passion you have, every single dream you have, knows every single hurt you've been through or what you're going through. And He is the only one that can give you purpose, healing, and forgiveness, and peace. And the truth is, it will rock your world to the better. It will, in fact, give you the lifeline that you have been searching, the lifeline that you've been praying for. And the Bible talks about that it adopts you into a royal family. You become a royal priesthood. And so maybe you grew up, and you grew up in a broken home, your parents were divorced, and you had a hard time with your relationship with your dad, with your mom. The truth is, when you experience what Easter is about, and you find who Christ is, you become into a royal family. You are not a castaway. You are not someone who is shunned, shamed on. You are precious. You are a beautiful daughter. You're a beautiful, handsome son to God. This morning, did Jesus really come back to life? And is He alive today? Let's look at Scripture to answer our question found in Luke 24, 1 through 8. The first point that explains why Jesus truly lived and rose from the grave is this, that the gospel stands or falls on the reality that Christ rose from the dead according to the Scriptures. Brother Eric mentioned it a while ago, that if Christ did not rise from the grave, then our faith is meaningless. Then me standing here would just be a noise to you. There's no truth into what I'm sharing to you about Jesus if Jesus never rose from the grave and is alive today. Let's read our scripture today from Luke 24, 1 through 8. But on the first day of the week at early dawn, they went to the tomb, taking the spices they had prepared. And they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they went in, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were perplexed about this, behold, two men stood by them in dazzling apparel. And as they were frightened and bowed their faces to the ground, the men said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you, while he was still in Galilee, that the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and on the third day rise." And they remembered his words. Church, Jesus rising from the grave is the reason why our faith is the truth. The reason why he is the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus proved to his disciples and to everyone that he is God when he rose from the grave. Again, no other religions or faiths have the same backing and truth about their God. Muhammad didn't rise from the grave. Confucius didn't rise from the grave. Gandhi didn't rise from the grave. But again, the reason why Christianity spread is not because it became a state religion. That's part of it. No, it's because, again, Christ truly rose from the grave and is alive. Today, we had our resurrection, our sunrise service, and thank you for those who came. And I want to invite the rest of our members or those who are visiting us this morning. If you've never experienced a sunrise service, please do so. We will do it again next year. Amen?
Amen.
Because again, to experience the sunrise, it gives you a small picture of Jesus rising from the grave and experiencing life in Him. But like I mentioned in our sunrise service, it won't mean anything to you if He is not the hope of your life. If He is not the living hope. Again, if Jesus never rose from the grave, According to scriptures, it's not just people saying Jesus rose from the grave. No. Luke wrote it. John wrote about it. Matthew wrote about it. Mark wrote about it. It was part of Christian history. They knew that Jesus rose from the grave. And it proved. Again, if